It is September 6th of 2002, and I'm about to start on the remodel project, adding on a third car garage, master bedroom, bathroom addition to the house. And so I thought, before we did that whole, start that whole process, that I'd walk through here and just kind of look at, you know, the way it was or is or whatever. So I just walked by the newly planted lawn I just planted today. Took those thundercloud plums out of there that were there for the last 30 years. And so here in the next few days, we're gonna be taking down the RV shed, and the RV's been gone for 10 years or more. Take this down and put an addition on here that will start just about where the power meter is there on the side of the house, just a foot or so behind that, and then run the full length of the side of the house. Again, once the shed is gone, I'm gonna kind of miss this shed because it's been great for being able to park the little utility trailer under here and El Camino, although the new third car garage will be a lot better for the El Camino than this unconditioned shed. But yeah, the way it was, going to start working on some of the plumbing under the house tomorrow. That's the next piece, and then moving the heat pump. It's going to end up back here on the back of the house. Start on that after the plumbing. The chimney for the pellet stove is kind of remains about where it is. Where the chimney is will be where the new bathroom is, or thereabouts. And that chimney will run up through a chase along with some plumbing vent and whatnot. Most all of the utilities, plumbing, heating, whatnot, I think is going to be able to come through where that existing crawl space hole is down there at the bottom. That's the grand plan anyway. But I think this yard is going to change fairly considerably. Going to have to take out, I don't know, one or two of these first Lelands here. And obviously all this gate and all this business goes away. And then across the back, see I'm kind of standing about where the corner of the new building will be, right in here. So got a couple shrubs that are gonna have to go away. So I had to stop and go warn Cindy that I'm gonna walk through here, but just thought I'd look at the way the yard and patio here is at the end of September 2022. Looking back over that way, kind of all gonna change. Hopefully the maple tree can remain unchanged. Fuchsias have done pretty good this year. Cindy ran in the house, but so yeah, the rest of the yard's kind of in shape. Kind of sad to see fall coming and lose this, because we'll be moving indoors for winter and losing all this nice outdoor space. And there's Ted waiting for me to throw the ball or whatever, chase him around. But that's kind of the state of things here at the end of summer 2022 and pre-construction of the new bed bath addition. I'm gonna take a pass through the patio just 'cause. Music going out here and just kind of enjoying the afternoon. One of the joys of retirement, being able to have a little relaxation time on a weekday afternoon. And one look last look down this way where the new addition's gonna be. Get out of the sunlight here if I can. There we go. So things will look quite different here a year from now, assuming the county approves the permit, which I've had in now for about 3 months waiting for them. They not only want my money, but they want a lot of time. But cousin Terry's son David's going to get the RV shed for his toys, so that's good. Anyway, that's where we're going, and as I work on this project, I'm going to try and take videos right along so we can kind of keep track of progress. Upward and onward. It is excavation day. I think it's about the 17th of October, 16th or 17th of October, I don't know. But just been working at this here for an hour or so. And they'll have it knocked out today. It's got a nice machine, doing a good job. Jason's here giving me a hand, kind of just any of the little handwork that's got to go on as we go. I'm still over here. So, looking good. December 9th. Pour on this footing. It's quite a different process than it was 30 years ago. It is January the 4th, and for January, it's a fairly reasonable weather day. At least it's not raining. I haven't walked through for a while, but just kind of been working here for a few hours and thought I'm going to stop and grab a little video of this before I get any farther. But I have got the mud seals all bolted down and just putting on the ledger and the rim joist here, getting ready to put the joist hangers on, and actually I'm hoping to get some joist hung, maybe all of them. I don't know, it's almost noon, so I may not get them all today, but again, trying to get this floor set. Travis is bringing his father-in-law over on Saturday, and he's a plumbing expert, a longtime plumber, so I'm going to get some advice from him on how to get the plumbing right so it'll be approved when inspection time comes. So that's about it. I think the last video that I had was probably a couple of minutes maybe of when they were pouring the footing. So it's been 2 or 3 weeks. I've been through the holidays. I did quite a bit of plumbing on sprinkler lines and drain lines and what around the perimeter of the foundation. But that's where I'm at here this morning. And it's been a while, but I'm gonna try to do a better job of taking videos as I go along. But again, January the 3rd, this is where I am. It is just about 5 o'clock here on January the 25th, and I had the lumber delivery today. Shy the subfloor material, they screwed that up, but I'll be here in the morning. And I've got some framers lined up to help out, and I think they're gonna start tomorrow or Friday, I'm not sure, it depends on the weather. But been a few days since I walked through. I think I'm pretty well prepared to nail down the subfloor here. I've got a row of bridging in here. I got the plumbing complete. And again, I don't remember where I was when I took the last video. Complete might be a little bit of a stretch. I've got it roughed in and had Travis's father-in-law, the plumber, here to kind of buy off on my work, and it's just kind of stuck together loosely in there, no glue, but I've got a plan anyway, pieces and parts in place. So things will start to change here pretty quickly now, and the framers, again, weather permitting, I think it'll take a couple of weeks, and we could be standing here with the trusses on and be ready for roofing, which would be sweet. I enjoy the indoor components of this work far more than the dirt work and the, you know, right here in the ground. But anyway, I hope this, it's just about dark. We can see the outdoor lights have come on already, but like I say, ready to take on some pretty significant changes here in the next couple of weeks. So hope to keep up with the videos as we go. It is a little after 5 on January the 30th. Had a couple guys helping frame today, and made some headway. Got some exterior walls stood up. I think by the end of tomorrow night we should get that garage up and be pretty close to being ready for trusses. Getting dark out here, and see all the lights are already on, but looks like this camera's still got enough light to pick that up, but kind of making some headway for the end of day one framing. But feeling pretty good about it. Cold out here, I don't know, my watch says it's 34 degrees, but it's a little chilly. Been chilly all day. So again, it is just about 5 o'clock here on January the 31st. The framers just left here a little bit ago, made some headway today. Getting close, a little more sheeting, probably half day tomorrow, and we'll be ready for trusses. So again, making some headway. Kind of get a sense for the feel of the whole thing. She did cheating on, so what will be the bedroom windows, bathroom frame for a couple of pocket doors. Again, making headway. It is February 9th, Thursday morning at 7:30, and we're having trusses delivered. This big truck out here, there's just got one long girder truss that goes all the way across. That's our little stack over there. We're going to be booming it out here onto the rooftop in just a couple of minutes. Definitely know what they're doing. Sit that down up there on the roof. And all we've had to do on the ground here is cut loose the chains. So the truss delivery guys just left. And got my framer guys coming to work on this with me today, but I don't remember exactly when the last video I posted when I walked through here. I think it was the other night after we framed these walls. So, but this is going to be a major step forward here if we can get these trusses up in the next day or two, weather permitting. But got the siding peeled up there the other day. Get that bathroom window out probably this morning. But it's just screwed in. So we'll see how that goes. But working out about as planned. So we'll see what she looks like by the end of the day. Okay, end of the day, Thursday, February the 9th, about 5 o'clock out here. Guys just took off. We got a fair amount of these trusses up there today. I just finished cutting the siding back for that along the rake there. That siding at the top, got a good part of these trusses up, the hip up on the back. Kind of start to see how this thing is going to come together. A little hard to see there, but anyway, I'll walk back here towards the back. Just picking up the tools. Much left to do. This looks like the eave is going to tie into that fascia. I don't know if you can see that from here, but soffit blocks in, but it should blend in right into the other roof. I don't know if we'll get that frame tomorrow or not. It's supposed to rain some, so I'm not sure how this is going to go. And we're still kind of weather tight on the old roof. Don't want to get too much of that torn off and then end up in a rainstorm. But, so I'll try to see if I can do this tomorrow night, see where we're at. Okay, it is Sunday, February the 12th, and I think it's been a couple of days since I've been out here with the camera, but the framers have made pretty good headway here late in the week, last week. Got the fascia boards all up and trusses set. Again, I can't remember exactly what this looked like the last time I was out here, but anyway, this is looking pretty good. Got, like I say, they got the fascias up, trusses up. It's supposed to rain pretty hard tomorrow, so I don't think we're going to get much accomplished tomorrow, but then Tuesday again, it's going to dry out. I think we'll have all of the roof sheeting up on Tuesday. Andy and I worked back here all weekend for a while, both days this weekend anyway. I don't think see, you can't see much from here, but we did the overframing that's over the top of the family room, and then roof sheet and sheeted and put the roofing underlayment on this whole back side this weekend. Again, you can see I've got some gutters, old gutters up, tacked up there, just kind of ready for a little bit of a monsoon tomorrow. But again, once that clears, I believe we'll have the roofing on by the end of this coming week. So here we go. It is roofing day. Stoneway Roofing bringing the materials. We're gonna boom it right up onto the roof. These roofers came recommended by Andy's buddy Jeremy, and so far so good. They seem like they got their act together. All right, it is Saturday, February the 18th. And haven't been out here for a couple of days, but as I thought in the last video, the roofers did get done a day or two ago now, but it took them a little longer than planned, but got it done. Looks good. They did what they said they were going to do when they said they were going to do it, so that's always a bonus. Get back over here, can't really see it, but got a couple of skylights installed, so I have got one quote on gutters, and we'll see how that turns out. Got a couple, gonna get a couple more numbers, but yeah, this is nice. Nice to have it dried in inside. Back here, got this all covered up. The portion that Andy and I framed and sheeted last weekend. All done, and look across there, pretty flat. We were worried there might be a little dip up there where the new and old roofs came together, and we did a little feathering in, but I think it looks pretty good. So from this valley in the corner all the way around, at least now I can work on the plumbing and the rest of it in the dry. So there we go. Just for the record here, still the 18th, but I took our patio lights and put LED bulbs in them last night and put that up in here. So kind of brightened this up, made this a workable space. Here's where the bathroom will be, pocket door, shower over there in the corner. So, like I said, a lot nicer to work inside here now. I'll get going on the plumbing and electrical and keep rolling. I just thought I would take a short video of this plumbing drain system. I just finished putting this in yesterday. I had started before the subfloor material was on, so it was a little easier to get at some of this stuff, and particularly over near where the toilet is at, early in the spring, or last summer, I guess, I'd run the 3-inch line all the way to the other end of the house and had it stubbed up right here next to this old access door. Then did the rough-in again before the subfloor, and then just did these drains hit the for the shower and the two sinks yesterday. I think it all went pretty well. A little bit of a hassle, but
All in all, it's about done. Got a little bit of copper that I'm going to work on under here today, and then I'll have everything stubbed up through the floor.
Okay, I have been plumbing for the last few days. It is like something like March the 4th or 5th, I'm not sure. on the top side here, now I've got the fresh water run up here to both the sinks, and due to blocking underneath and whatever, all the reasons that nothing can be straightforward. Particularly when it came to this shower valve mechanism, turned out to be far more complicated than I thought it was gonna have to be. But I got it in here. Like I said, but more complicated than I thought, but this dual shower head thing and the transfer valve, which is the upper one here, and using two legs of the three available, and it's just a lot of messing around. And then up over the top, gonna have a shower head coming down out of the ceiling, and then another one come down to the hand unit on the wall over here. Then things in the ceiling get a little tricky because there's got to be a light fixture up there. I couldn't just run that pipe right straight through. I had to put an elbow in it to go around a can light. And all in all, just a bunch of messing around. But kind of glad to be done with this. Got a little blocking to put in and then clean up the mess. And, well, pressure tested, I guess that's the next big thing, which is why I've got this little yoke thing right on here. I've got to put a pressure gauge on there and introduce some air pressure and make sure I don't have any leaks, but another step forward. It is March the 15th, about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I've been working up here most of the day, cutting through the plumbing vents, of which there are three. The other one down there, and three more devices, I guess, or whatever, chimney, the sun tunnel solo tube device that is over the shower bathroom, shower area of the bathroom, and a bathroom fan. So it's been a little bit of a project here today, but got it done, feel pretty good about that. I'm gonna come back up and touch some of the nail heads with a little bit of sealant tomorrow. I don't have any on hand, but so this is a kind of a milestone to get all that stuff cut through. Skylight was cut through and installed before the roofers took care of that one. So anyway, that's kind of the day's accomplishments, and back really ready to get rolling on the electrical now.